Well, almost three times the passing yards, almost twice as many first downs as you look at the stats, and total domination. Yeah. I guess one thing you can hang your hat on, the last couple of drives for Oregon State, they put together some things and got 3 points. They're going to get the ball first.
Yeah, and you had to get something there at the end of the half because you were having no success stopping Marcus Mariota. That offense, they ran 37 plays, 19 runs, 18 passes. They averaged almost 10 yards per play. So the offense for Oregon, virtually unstoppable in that first half.
Let's see if the Beavers can get something on the kick return, a short kick from the 12-yard line, but they only get it out to about the 22, and that's where Sean Mannion and company are going to start from the 22-yard line. On a stretch play to Woods. Storm Woods, nice game. Good way to start the third quarter, a pickup of 9. Of 8 by Woods, who's closing in on 100 in the game. They give it to him again. Kept his balance, put his hand down. Got about 5. And again, long handoff. Woods only got action to get back to the line of scrimmage, barely. A loss of a couple of feet by Woods, so it's second down and 11. Give it to him again. Try to establish something, so as Todd said, maybe they can play action and go on top, and that's third down. Your duck or two.
That has battled an ankle injury for most of the season. You see that brace on his left ankle, and that has been bothering him virtually the whole year. He's missed a couple games because of it.
Balducci, a guy from about 90 minutes up the road. Third and 7, possible blitz coming up the middle. They back out of that, but the pressure is too much for Mannion already. Prevo coming from the outside with a sack.
Beating the left tackle, speed rush to the outside. Mannion not able to step up in the pocket.
Costo had to handle a one-hopper snap, too, and Lloyd back-to-back fair catches in about the same spot on the field for him. And right now, Auburn is leading Alabama, we understand, 33-21. And here, number 2, Oregon, looking for more. Freeman, all the way down to the 35-yard line.
Just basic run, just basic inside zone run. And bad gap responsibility on the backside of that run. Freeman, with vision, just kind of slid to the backside and got a big gain out of it.
Got 32 yards. They give it to him again. This time, maybe 3.
The development of Freeman and the consistency of Mariota has made this offense just ridiculous.
And here comes the athletic ability of the quarterback, who slides after picking up the first down.
The things that's been key for him this year is he's been healthy the whole season. And that hasn't always been the case for Mariota. He's been productive.
On first down at the Beaver 25. Play action, plenty of time. Going to the corner of the end zone, and too much for Stanford, but we've got a flag.
But too much contact.
Interference. Defense number 8. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
You take a look at the end of this play, and there's the grab. Just held the arm down, and can't do that. You know, the thing about Mariota, and I've made this comment, we've seen some good quarterbacks this year. The thing about him is he is an NFL talent arm quarterback, but he's an elite athlete as well with the speed.
Play action for him here. Swings it out to Marshall. Marshall inside the 10, taken out of bounds roughly over there at the 8-yard line.
He has NFL caliber talent in terms of throwing the football.
Freeman gets the carry from the 7. Got it to the 5. Jalen Grimble, a junior out of Las Vegas, went off under his own power. He was in on the tackle, 1 of 2 he's made tonight. And his night might be over, as it was the knee that had that heavy brace on it that he was favoring. Meanwhile, Marcus Mariota throws a slant, incomplete. Intended for Dwayne Stanford. Devin Allen was also in the vicinity. Oregon on an Indian Trail, North Carolina, from 22 yards away. And he's got it up and good. Right here, number 2, Oregon is holding court on the road in Corvallis against their arch rivals, leading 33-3. Maribel, it's his best return of the night. Got it out to the 36-yard line as we go down to Holly.
Well, it is a very cold night here in Corvallis, but Oregon has these very fancy benches. They are propane heated. But look at this. This is hot air blowing out of these that they place their helmets on. So when they put their helmet on to run back onto the field, it is nice and toasty inside. But I would like to file a formal protest because there's the offense. We saw Marcus Mariota. And then look at the offensive line. They are on these cold, hard steel aluminum benches.
But Holly, look, they have short sleeves on. That they have to do that.
Offensive linemen are people, too. I just want people to understand that.
I know, but they've got a lot of body.
They got more padding.
Weight and support and, you know, body heat.
Nobody looks up for offensive linemen more than Holly does. Haskins is the tailback right now for the Beavers. He gets the carry here. Bounces it out of bounds after about a one-yard gain. In our ESPN grouping poll, he's the number one guy with Melvin Gordon number two. I know Gordon had a good game against Minnesota today, around 150 and a couple of touchdowns. Title game at Levi Stadium in Santa Clara against Arizona coming up next week, and they're the only team that's put a blemish on the Ducks' record so far. Another good run by Storm Woods. There's what he's done, and he's done more than the rest of the group together. They fake it to him here. Mannion wanted to go right. Now comes back near side and broken up. Last year at Autzen Stadium, both teams were well over 500. Mannion fires far side. That one hung a little bit too long. Third and 10, going to throw a screen pass. Woods broke one tackle. He won't get away from the second, though. He got to the 30.
Boy, there are three Oregon Duck players down. Armstead for the second time. Tony Washington down. And Olomu slow getting up.
Fourth and five. Throw in the flat. The blockers are out there for Woods, and he's got a first down.
He's done a little bit of everything. Nice job getting him the ball in a position where he could catch and get right up the field. And then he does the rest.
Is definitely shouldering the load. And he goes forward inside the 20 on this one. Just inside the Duck 20. Nice play fake. Mannion's going for it all here and overshot everybody. Tied with Andrew Luck in Pac-12 history with 82 career touchdown passes, but none tonight so far. Might have one here. And he does. Hunter Jarman, touchdown. Up and good. First touchdown of the night for Oregon State. And now Garrett Owens to kick. Charles Nelson from about the 8-yard line. And gets it out to the 28.
For Marcus Mariota, you wonder, how do his skills translate to the NFL? Watch this throw. This was from last year. Left hash, throwing to the right corner pylon of the end zone. That's an NFL throw. Tonight, stepping up in the pocket and driving the ball down the field. That's what NFL guys want to see a quarterback do. And then whether it's a designed run or a scramble, his ability as a runner and his speed at 6'4", 220, I think just gives him a unique skill set to take to the next level. And I think he can do it all, run and throw.
And you can see by the numbers, he has done both tonight again. Play action, this time got away somehow. There's a flag down, but he eluded the rush and incomplete on the throw.
Holding, 78 offense, 10-yard penalty, will be second down, remains first down. Correction, first down.
Marcus Mariota, when you consider some of the recent Heisman winners, from Cam Newton on through RG3 and Johnny Manziel, Jameis Winston, pretty impressive stuff.
Yep.
Total yards and total touchdowns. That's why you see 45 touchdowns there. He has three touchdown passes tonight to make it 35 and then one on the ground. Here comes Byron Marshall again.
The unselfishness of Byron Marshall, a 1,000-yard rusher a year ago. They said, hey, we got this freshman, Royce Freeman, that we're going to make our feature back this year. We'd like to put you more out as the hybrid kind of guy. And he has been an outstanding leader for this football team.
He's to Marcus Mariota's left. They fake it to him. Marcus is going to run. And he's outrunning guys that should have had an angle. But we got a flag down in the backfield again.
Holding, 54 offense. 10-yard penalty. Main first down.
The seventh different starting line combination. There's the hold right there. Amani Stevens, the center, in there in place of the injured Hieronymus Grassu. Steve Greatwood patching that line together and still being as productive as they've been.
Mariota throws again to the middle of the field, and it's Carrington off to the races. Carrington down inside the 10.
Steps up in the pocket. Watch him step up. Feel the rush. Step up and then drive the ball to the middle of the field.
Down inside the 10 and just outside the 6. First and goal. Freeman straight ahead to the 3, maybe the 2. Second down and goal. Freeman. Everybody pushing for extra yardage. He's got it around the 1 yard line. Auburn leading Alabama the last time we checked. If that should hold up. And Alabama just scored, the truck tells me. I shouldn't have said anything. I was about to say that Oregon would be number one on Tuesday.
98 on defense. Helmet came off. He must leave the game for one down. Fourth down.
They lose Hautau because his helmet came off for a play. Marcus Mariota says, you know, I've done everything else tonight. I'm going to give you a little help here.
Yeah.
This might be his number right here. Fourth down and goal. Mariota, empty backfield. It is his number. Touchdown.
Wow.
His second of the night on the ground.
Called quarterback run all the way. They pull the center, Hamani Stevens. He gets the key block on Dylan Wynn.
With 2:19 remaining in the quarter, about to be 40-10, and it is.
I believe in Oregon State. I believe in her traditions. A heritage from the deeds and dreams of yesterday. I believe in her sportsmanship and honor, a reality with the students of today. I believe in her aspirations and her ideals. The assurance of a magnificent tomorrow.
And now for Oregon, that makes 7 consecutive games of 40 points or more that they've scored. Ever since that Arizona loss, which seems ages ago now, this Oregon offense has played at a highly effective and efficient level.
And Todd, it's their 6th straight game of 500 yards or more in total offense. They're at 505, so both those streaks stay alive. Kick goes to the 6. To Marable on the kick return. And again, he's getting a little bit better on about every return. Out to the 35-yard line. Alabama trailing Auburn. Oregon rolling here. They're going to remain just once beaten. They'll be 11-1. Florida State again survived, I guess you could put it, against Florida. And Mississippi State lost, so they're going to come out of the top 4 on Tuesday night, we would be assuming, with 2 losses. Mannion, I don't know if he was hit as he threw or not, but that ball came out kind of funny. In thrilling fashion, we might add.
And they did that in Eugene, too. That's the other thing that's impressive about what Arizona did that night.
Sean Mannion over the middle, got the first down. Across midfield, and it's Malik Gilmore this time. They go back to 2 tight ends and put Woods behind the fullback, Ortiz. And they give it to Storm. About a 3-yard pickup. Play action, Mannion, far sideline, and broken up. Nice play on the ball by Eric Dargan. Victor Bolden, the intended receiver. Number 2 Ducks. Right now, 15 minutes away from going to 11-1 on the season. Hope you had a good Thanksgiving. We had a little gathering with a good portion of the crew on Thursday nights. Trying to wear off our 5.5-hour flights and our 2-hour drives.
Holding, number 13 on the defense. 10-yard penalty. Yardage results in the first down.
3 tight end set again for the Beavers. They've used that a lot tonight. Haven't really gotten the ball to the tight ends much. Here's a bootleg off play action. Sean Mannion going back to the sideline. Got it to his most productive player, Storm Woods.
Able to slip out and down the sideline. And Mannion able to find him over there.
23-yard pickup, and it's first and goal. I've only got one wide receiver, so it might be his call again. First and goal. On the stretch to the left, and he's in. Walks in. Touchdown. Garrett Owens for the point after. Things looking a little more mix up there. But the Bengals have a slight lead by way of a tie. Let's take a look at our Pacific Life game summary. As you might expect, mostly Oregon. Freeman on a toss for Marcus Mariota, one of his three scoring tosses of the night. And then this one to Byron Marshall, who broke a tackle at the 35 and took it the rest of the way. And then Marcus Mariota doing it with his legs as well. 23-yard touchdown run. They've done it about every conceivable way tonight offensively, and they lead 40-17 with 14 minutes to play. Play fake and a strike down the sideline. What a throw to Dwayne Stanford. Now that one covered a lot of ground and it got there in a hurry, Pat.
Well, and you see with their play action, and this is a throw right on a rope, right between the corner and the safety coming over. But Marcus Mariota, he's faking to the back, but his eyes are not looking on a run fake. His eyes are looking at coverage. And as soon as he came out of that fake, he delivered the strike.
Now they put it on the ground to Charles Nelson. And he's going to go down for a loss of about four.
It's interesting to watch Marcus Mariota and how he uses his eyes in this offense. If it's a zone read type play, you see his eyes are down on the defensive front, reading whether to hand the ball off or to keep it. If it's a pass, play action pass, his eyes are up, looking at coverage.
There's the play fake. His eyes are getting big right now.
Yeah.
Let's check in with Holly.
Well, Oregon has done something with their quarterbacks for years, clear back to Dennis Dixon, where they train this very sophisticated system with their eyes. But it's a new system they're using now with Marcus Mariota. It's like a giant iPad. He has to go through a series of progressions, move his eyes around quickly, and they're hoping to get it where it's a big thing where he can actually move like he would in the pocket and train and hit different targets with his eyes. But very sophisticated eye training to help these quarterbacks process information so quickly with their eyes, and Marcus is one of the very best at doing that.
That's pretty cool. A third down and 20 here. Crowd, what's left of it, is trying to get into it for Oregon State defense.
That's number one.
Need to get to the 35-yard line of Oregon State's low snap. Marcus handles it, steps around the pressure, and now he's going down again.
There was some acceleration by DJ Alexander. Showed it on this play. Watch number four read and accelerate to the quarterback. Wow.
Third-year starter, and he just tracked down one of the fastest guys.
He was so fast, he ran out of my circle. Wrong guy.
So fourth down in a punting situation. And this one will roll down around the 26-yard line. They got a quick score and an onside kick. They might get this thing interesting. That throw right in front of the Oregon bench is... No, Holly says nobody's warming up. That would be Lockie if they go to him. Woo, nice hit.
Quick read on the wide receiver screen.
And Victor Bolden gets blown up by Joe Walker.
Joe Walker is just a steady guy. You know, he's in the right place at the right time.
Mannion steps up, wants to throw, sidearms it out there, and it was almost picked off. Around his own 15. End over end job. This one's fielded by Lloyd. Does a two-step and then a two-yard walk. Marcus Mariota on the last offensive series for the Ducks. Took a couple of big-time shots. Sacked here.
The first one was his head. Yeah, head on the ground. And then the last one we saw on the third down play, Alexander has to wait. Landing on top at the end.
This is where your center, Hamani Stevens, says, bro, you got some grass or something on your visor, as Hamani becomes the human windshield wiper. Freeman on the ground for a couple. That's amazing, isn't it?
Yep.
That stat is going to hold up again tonight unless the score changes. That doesn't bode well for next week against Arizona.
No. Already down, of course, Farrell Brown, and we talked about earlier, Bayless in there and in place of him.
Freeman, good run short of the first down, and Alexander again making the stop. And Freeman's got it. And he's got a couple more after that. They were trailing in the fourth quarter, they being the Ducks. And Marcus found Keenan Lowe for a 9-yard touchdown. That tied it at 24. Arizona answered. Terrace Jones-Grigsby scored on a 1-yard run. And Oregon's final drive ended with Scooby Wright stripping the ball from Marcus Mariota. Arizona won it 34-24. And Scooby did much the same to Arizona State. Is that Thursday or Friday, whenever we watch the game? I don't know. We watched so many ball games Friday.
Yep.
Marshall in motion to the slot. The run comes the other way. Freeman, they stretch it out nicely this time. And again, it was Dylan Wynn. They're dropping like ducks. They don't want that to happen with a big game next week. And then who knows what's beyond. If they win that one, we know what's beyond. They win the Pac-12 title game. They're in the 14 playoff. Here's Freeman on another big run. Nice counter. Saw the opening come to his backside. It was set to go to the left. And he rips it off to the right side for 18 yards. This is something Oregon doesn't usually do, and that's time-consuming drives. But this one, they've used up some clock.
It's off to Steve Greatwood, the offensive line coach, for his ability to kind of mix and match here over the last 6 weeks.
Mariota going for it all. Corner, touchdown, Charles Nelson.
Inside coverage by the safety, Ryan Murphy. Watch how hard inside the safety is at the top left of your screen. That's an easy post-corner route for Charles Nelson. Just don't know that there's a more efficient offense in college football right now. Not only are they productive and explosive, they don't turn it over.
Then they got this guy running the show. 59-yard drive, 8 plays. Scoring toss number 4 for Marcus Mariota to Charles Nelson, 47-17.